Over the years, NBA stars have accumulated massive net worths from their large contracts and endorsement deals. Some have stacked their bank accounts even more through different investments. Here are the 10 richest NBA players of all time, and a few of them may catch you by surprise. Number 10, Hakeem Olajuwon, $200 million. The number one overall pick from the 1984 draft, Olajuwon had a good enough career for people to not roast the Rockets for taking him instead of MJ, who went third overall. Unlike the Trailblazers taking Sam Bowie with the second pick, not only was Hakeem dominant enough to escape that drama, but his play also helped him earn over $107 million from his contracts over his career. Since then, he's launched his own clothing line and made some seriously successful real estate investments that have netted him over $100 million. Number 9, David Robinson, $200 million. Over the course of his stellar playing career, the Admiral earned over $116 million from his contracts. Since his retirement, Robinson has launched two private equity funds. Admiral Capital was launched in 2007 and raised $115 million. It will go on to acquire $350 million worth of real estate assets. Due to the tremendous success from his first venture, Robinson decided to go for two as he launched his second fund in 2015 with the goal of raising $175 million to invest in more real estate. Number 8. Grant Hill, $250 million. Hill made the majority of his money during his playing career. His earnings were fairly balanced between his contracts and endorsements. Over his 18-year career, he earned $140 million from his salaries and $120 million from endorsements. In 1997, he signed a 7-year deal with Fila worth $80 million, which was the largest shoe contract in history at the time. Fila still gives him money to this day, as the two parties agreed to a lifetime deal in 2018 that pays Hill more than $10 million a year to endorse the company. In terms of investments, Grant was part of a group who purchased the Atlanta Hawks for an estimated $850 million in 2015. Even though he is extremely well off, Hill has hosted NBA Inside Stuff on NBA TV and served as a sports broadcaster. Number 7. Vinny Johnson, $400 million. Vinny only made $5 million over his 14-year NBA career, as he was primarily just the sixth man for the Pistons, which is a drop in the bucket compared to his net worth today. After spending a decade playing for Detroit, Johnson started his own automobile supply company 3 years following his retirement and fittingly named it the Piston Group. The Piston Group took off in popularity and quickly became the leading supplier of automobile parts to major automobile companies, such as GM and the Ford Motor Company. Today, Johnson serves as the chairman and CEO, and the Piston Group is one of the world's largest minority-owned businesses and earns over $3 billion in annual revenue. Number 6. Shaquille O'Neal, $400 million. With a personality as big as his physical stature, the Big Diesel has combined his personality with his fame from being one of the most unguardable players in recent NBA history to become crazy wealthy. Even as a player, Shaq was getting creative with how to make money off the court, as he starred in such movies as Blue Chips and Kazam. These were signs of what was to come in the future, as O'Neal would make a plethora of appearances on people's screens through various reality series and other productions. He's even been in some video games outside of NBA 2K over the years. Shaq made over $200 million from endorsements during his time as an NBA superstar. He has done more than just rack in endorsement money. In 2019, Shaq joined the board of directors of Papa John's and also bought 30% of a 9-unit franchise of Papa John's in Atlanta. Not many professional athletes have been more active with endorsements than Big Diesel. It also helped that he made $292 million in salary over his NBA career. Number 5. LeBron James, $500 million. For a guy who has accomplished so much on the basketball court, it's interesting that LeBron would refer to potentially becoming a billionaire as his biggest milestone in the 2014 interview with GQ. Well, it appears that James is about to reach that landmark, as Forbes has reported that LeBron is expected to cross $1 billion in career earnings in 2021. He will become just the fifth active athlete to reach that milestone of $1 billion in career earnings, joining Tiger Woods, Floyd Mayweather, Cristiano Ronaldo, and Lionel Messi. So, how has LeBron gotten here, other than being one of the greatest basketball players of all time? The first part has helped him earn over $600 million before taxes in salaries over his career. His dominance on the court has also led to him securing a handful of prominent endorsements, such as his lifetime deal with Nike that he signed in 2015 that could be worth more than $1 billion alone. James also owned 1% of Beats by Dre before the company sold to Apple for $3 billion, making his cut $30 million. LeBron has shown zero signs of slowing down with his abilities to dominate in basketball or earning money. Number 4. Kobe Bryant, $600 million. A legend who we will never forget for what he did on and off the court, Kobe succeeded at everything he put his mind to. The 18-time All-Star and 5-time NBA champ earned just over $328 million in salary over the course of his playing career. During that same time period, Bryant also made around $350 million from endorsements. His fame was not confined to the United States, as his reach stretched all around the globe and specifically thrived in China. This allowed Kobe to sign Chinese-specific endorsement deals with companies like Alibaba and Sina.com. One of Bryant's best investments and a sign of his insane vision involved the sports drink Body Armor. While the drink's popularity has grown tremendously in popularity in recent years, it was not always that well known. In 2014, Kobe purchased a 10% equity stake in Body Armor for $6 million. Fast forward 4 years, and the company generated $400 million in 2018 alone, and Coca-Cola purchased a stake in Body Armor that valued the company as a whole at $2 billion, which meant Kobe's initial investment of $6 million was now worth $200 million before taxes. Before his tragic death, Kobe was making serious money moves. An icon taken away too soon. Rest in peace, Mamba. Number 3. Junior Bridgman, $600 million. One of the only names on the list who the average sports fan may not be familiar with, Junior Bridgman's net worth is almost definitely more than your favorite player's. To be fair though, it did not come from his playing career, as his highest single season salary was just $350,000. Bridgman was primarily a sixth man in the NBA, but his financial decisions have been MVP caliber. Typically, when you hear about an athlete working at a fast food establishment, that means something went wrong with their career or financials. However, that wasn't the case with Junior. During the offseason, he would work in a local Wendy's to learn about the business. By the time he retired from the league, Bridgman owned 3 Wendy's. He started Bridgman Foods, Inc. and kept buying more and more Wendy's until he eventually owned 160 of them and 120 Chili's locations. Junior became the second largest Wendy's franchise owner in the world. He is now the president and CEO of Coca-Cola Heartland Bottling Company, which makes around $650 million in revenue today. While he was never an NBA All-Star, Junior Bridgman is a Hall of Famer when it comes to making money. Number 2. Magic Johnson, $600 million. Known for being the straw that stirred the Showtime Lakers, Magic had quite the NBA playing career. But somehow, it pales in comparison to what he has done off the court with his financials. And that's saying something, as Johnson was a 5-time NBA champion, 3-time NBA Finals MVP, 3-time league MVP, and 12-time All-Star. After his stellar career came to a close, Magic became an entrepreneur, a very good entrepreneur. He launched a business empire called Magic Johnson Enterprises that is now valued at over $1 billion. In 1994, Magic paid $10 million for 5% of the Lakers, which he then sold in 2010 for an estimated $50 to $60 million. That was a good year for Magic, to say the least, as he also sold his chain of Starbucks for $75 million in 2010. He then reinvested some of those profits 2 years later as him and a group of partners purchased the Los Angeles Dodgers for $2 billion. The Dodgers have established themselves as a perennial power in Major League Baseball, having made the playoffs in every season from 2013 to now and winning the World Series in 2010. So the team's value is only growing. Number 1. Michael Jordan, $1.6 billion. Just like on the basketball court, MJ is unstoppable when it comes to making money. Even though he's the greatest basketball player of all time, well, depending on who you talk to, Jordan only made less than $100 million through his contracts over his storied playing career. The majority of his net worth actually comes from stuff that Michael has done off of the court through endorsements and investments. Most notably, the Jordan brand has historically been his biggest moneymaker. As of 2015, MJ was reportedly making $100 million a year from Nike royalties alone. As unbelievable as it may seem, he actually makes more a year off of the Jordan brand than he did his entire NBA career. Another prominent source of wealth for Jordan involves his ownership of the Charlotte Hornets. He bought a majority stake in the team in 2010 when the team was valued at $175 million. Only 9 years later, the Hornets became worth $1.5 billion, so MJ agreed to sell a minority stake in the team. Unlike the team he owns and makes millions of dollars off of, Jordan always wins when it comes to investments or endorsements.